Yes, thank you, Phyllis, because I'm the only marketing arm, so I'm the best. That seems makes sense. So for in this bay, just to let you know that we're gonna have two main part. The first bay, which is this one, we're gonna have like around 30 minutes. But then I will try to make it shorter for you. That it's gonna include marketing and sales, and we're gonna talk about the launching campaign. I'm gonna go through very quick on what is the tip for the launching, and also we're gonna talk very quick about a brand advocacy campaign, any kind of concern, and finally, finally, the marketing and OTT strategy downscaling between me and Phyllis. And then marketing, you're gonna have a time of break, and then we're gonna coming back here. Anyone that doing marketing that you need to learn more about marketing tactics, then you come back here at 3:30 p.m. GMT plus 8. So that in this space, we're gonna talk about also the launching campaign, but then we're gonna go deeper into the case study, the tactic, and also a lot of things basically. And then you can also understand about what is the regional plan of marketing also. Okay, so right now let's just start. Okay, marketing and OTT synergy space. Let's say hi, because I think here some people don't know me or some people don't know Phyllis. I hope that you know. So I'm currently RM marketing for AP in last term and also in this term. Actually, in the past, I coming from ASA in Vietnam, and then I were MCVB B2C OTV. Yes, because it only me, right? So I'm gonna handle marketing for AP, and then also because only AP have marketing, so I also gonna support AI in global campaign or some other stuff. So hi OTT. So Phyllis, you can say something.
Oh, hi marketing. I love you guys a lot. Okay, other than OTT, you are the second favorite of it. Okay, our performance rely on you. Okay, so marketing, we love you so much. Thank you.
Marketing feel pressure. Marketing left the conversation. Okay, just kidding. So that's us, and we're gonna work with each other to ensure that I'm gonna help you to have the best campaign, the best digital marketing, and Phyllis gonna help you to have the best of marketing sales funnel and the best conversion rate and the packaging and also S&D. I mean a lot. Okay, now let's go to the first part about the launching. So in this launching, before we go into it, I would just let you understand and remember again about our brand. So I set program at the branded house, which is a house that including a lot of portfolio that contribute to the leadership development of young people. So GT, GVG, GTI, GTE, or even membership in the next year also gonna be a part in the portfolio. We differentiate ourselves, especially for GT, we need to differentiate ourselves from HR agency because our brand is about leadership, right? And also, as you know, right now, global talent and global teacher already become the game changer, and you are built to be the cash cow brand of the organization, and which means that right now we need to see how we can perform the product in the best day, and we can really make this product bringing the revenue for the organization in the upcoming time. And it's also the role of both marketing, sales, and CSP to make this thing happen. So that's why it's very important to synergy with marketing as always. And when you think about the new product, what I heard is maybe you're gonna feel, do we need to have a launching, like, or we just change the logo? Whether is it gonna be possibly or not? So to be honest, right, in my opinion, and also when I discussed with Phyllis, we aware that if we just changing the logo only, then this not gonna have us. To be honest, why? Because a quality product need to make yourself loud enough. So in the jungle of a lot of similar product in the market right now, especially for GT, there's a lot of agency do the job that better than you. And actually the customer will only looking for the top 3 to 5 product in a category or industry, and then they make decision already. But then right now, as a product in general and GT in specific is not the market leader. So we need to be very honest about this opinion. And because of that, our goal is gonna increase that state so that we can starting everything with a successful product launchings in the market, so that we can make, basically we can just say it out loud that, hey, we have a very amazing product. Young people, go exchange with us. And also, right now, because in the era of digital marketing, that support a lot of company in the product launching. So at the same time, it's easy for us to do any kind of product launching. But then at the same time, we have a lot of competitor in the market. When you do about when you want to launch anything, and because of that, we need a really good launching strategy, or at least a basic a single plan. Even it's gonna last you for very short time. Yeah, we need to say it loud. And before this, I want to remind you that don't start with what you have right now. You need to start with the understanding about what is the customer need. And then from here, you're going to build the package that can answer the need of the customer. So that's why it's the whole roadmap that you're already going through, understand the pain again, the uncovered problem, or understand about what is their opinion about the current product. And also, importantly, we need to understand what is the problem of the young people in this country and what is the benefit that this GT is going to bring for you. Why do we have a refresh order? Why we don't run the old GT? Why is it different? So this is something that as a product, you need to understand. And this is the basic thing that both of you, product and marketing, need to understand before you do anything related to GT. So right now, I want to show you something. I want to show you an example of how a brand launching the product. So this is one example of Pepsi, and they just launched this campaign in the beginning of this year. But I think they didn't know about the pandemic. But it's fine. Let's see it. I think you can find more about this one. So you mean this, because this is one of my favorite launching campaign of one of the favorite competitor of my favorite brand, which is basically I like Coca-Cola, but because Pepsi is a very big competitor, so I follow them. Okay, so what I just showing you is campaign that Pepsi just launched this beginning of the year, and how they launched. The reason why they launched this campaign and they launched this new refreshment message is because they want to approach the young people, which is the Gen Z, when people want to hear more about personal life. They want to get respect for their old personality, their old way, their old living style. And because of this kind of campaign, there's not a lot of changing in the product. But then there's a lot of changing in how they approach the customer, and they bring the Pepsi with a totally different message and totally different the way of living for the young people. And this campaign actually acquired one of successful campaign of Pepsi, and I think that you can learn from them. And basically what you can see is they launched a 30-second video about the young people living their old life, and it's it's very soft, it's very simple, but then at the same time, it's very loud. And because it's very loud, more people know about the brand and more young people know about it, and then the sale of Pepsi increasing. Oh. So also let's go back with Isaac. The first principle when we talk about campaign launching, as you can see right now, the product may not change the whole world. The product cannot change anything. And maybe the message that Pepsi is changing right now cannot change like everyone, but then at least it can change, it can be the life changing for the customer they are approaching. And any customer that they use the product of Pepsi, they will feel that, oh, I can be got respect for my old way of living. And also for Isaac, the way that we deliver the product cannot change the whole customer in the world, but then at least we with one good experience for the customer and with one amazing experience for customer, it can be a life changing for them. And also that's the reason why we keep improving the product and the portfolio that we are doing. Okay, so if you want to know about the detail of the campaign launching, you can go to this link. ISBiz.launch, yes. Okay, I don't know how to speak it. You can come here, but then you can commit to it later. If you come here, I would just have you to remind something that there's a lot of way for you to launch a campaign. You can learn on how the big company doing it, but then based on my knowledge and my experience, I see that in any kind of launching campaign, we always have this five thing that you need to always need to remember, and it's gonna help you a lot. So the first part, we need to think about building a marketing and also the resale funnel. For the product launching, what is resale? But it's not sale, because this launching cannot give you the direct result right away, but then it can help you a lot in attract more people that interest in the new product GTE, and also it can help you to have some qualified prospect in the future. After you have a very clear funnel for it, the second thing that we need to have is a strong package, a strong position, and a message. So for the package and the position, I think that this is something that you already done, but then for the message, this is the important part that we need to understand how we can communicate with customer. The next part is in a launching, don't just tell them about a base, don't just post a content originally, but then let's tell them an emotional leadership story about your product so that you can connect with them with the emotion. And you can tell them that because of this emotion, because of this problem, so our product is the solution for you. And also, let's tell it by a viral and a creative marketing campaign, because as I told you, in this campaign, we need to be loud. We need to be very, very, I'll say, loudly speaking to other, to the audience outside. So it needs to have a very strong campaign. The next one is the campaign need to have a lot of tactic to make it loud. We can have influencer, we can have PR, digital media, co-brand coordination, all the stuff. And in this part, there's a lot of things that marketing and sales can do together. Last but not least, good thing, take time. So there's tie up so that you need to be patient. And especially as I mentioned, launching campaign is not something to bring you the result, but then it's the first step for you to build the pool of customer right now so that in the future you can convert them. So how marketing and sales can synergy in this case? So for example, in the first step to build a marketing funnel, so marketing have to gonna be the one who build the funnel. But then for sale, you're gonna support for them in terms of support in the resale. So for example, like customer support or opportunity or sale pitch or something. So you can provide them, support them with this part or some activity. And then also need to ensure that any kind of funnel that marketing doing is also aligned with the sales funnel that you want in terms of timeline, in terms of number. Like for example, marketing do too many or do, and then, but then the campaign is too big and then it's late on the sign up campaign, then it's also not gonna be a good thing. The second is for the product packaging. So this is the part that both of you need to do together. There's no separate in this part. In the create a leadership story, also the same, because you are the product head of the organization or not of the product. So it's not only the role of marketing to do it, but then it's also you, how you and marketing understand about it, and then co-create a leadership story for the product launching. And then the role of marketing is you put everything in this product, the packaging, the position, the message into a viral campaign, and then you downscale it. And then during the implementation in the number four, when we talk, when we're working with the influencer, the BR, the digital media, and co-rank, there's a lot of things that marketing needs to manage with EST, LCBB, or even the agency to deploy the campaign and the tracking the data. But at this time, sales can support a lot in customer support, for especially for the pre-sale, especially for who interest, and then they want to understand more about the product, but then they didn't make decision. In the community content support, especially in this case, in this situation, we really need to build a customer loyalty. So community is a part that sales can actually support marketing very, very, a lot. And also for you are an influencer, is the part that the sales team can actually support marketing in you are also, and also in influencer or in connect the marketing with the returnee or the people that the micro influencer in the market, so that you can, spreading the brand even higher. And then both, you need to track the performance of the launching. Take time and wait for it. And as I say, because the launching campaign in us doesn't need to be a long campaign, it's gonna be a very short, but then it's loud. But then if marketing do it too long, then it's gonna affect to the attraction timeline and the sign up goal that you want to have. So if you come here to the link that I sent for you, you can have a very detailed read about the marketing funnel. The marketing funnel, how marketing gonna build it. You can also come here to see the sub note from my side about the package. So in terms of package, last time you also worked with Phyllis on viral packaging. And then in this case, I would recommend you to utilize that. I think Phyllis already give you the link. I forgot the link, sorry. You use that one, and then you and marketing gonna be the one who package every product together and make it super simple so that you can use this one in the promotion, in the launching campaign. Also, in the buzz seasoning and the masses, we need to understand that we already have the buzz seasoning and the benefit of the GTA, GTE, and also the message from the global campaign with Isaac. But then our role as a national head, we need to understand how this buzz seasoning and this message can be translated in my entity context. So we customize it, but then we don't change it. Yes, and also remember that the message that you and marketing gonna deliver is the promise, the big promise that you're gonna talk to the customer. So never go back on it, basically. Okay, and then for the leadership story and also make it hype, I also give the material and the stuff here. I think that you can, if you want to learn about it, you can read so that you can work with marketing better. Because in marketing, there's gonna be a lot of things that they need to actually on the job and implement it. Okay, so because, and then in the number five, very important timeline. Time is important. If you late for 1 week, you're gonna late for 1 month in customer timeline. So basically, as you can see here, this is my suggestion timeline for all the campaign that you can have, both you at marketing. As you can see that if you want to do any kind of brand advocacy campaign before you do the proper launching, you can do it. But then this brand advocacy campaign can be very quick. It's very short, like even lesser than 2 weeks, something. Oh yes, don't cry. Yes, I know this feeling. Okay, and then after you finish the brand advocacy, you can start for the launching. So in the launch, we're gonna have the relaunch, something in the relaunch, and then we launch it, and then we amplify, and then after we already have it, then it's the time for us to intensively go with the internship campaign. So in this part, as you can see, the launch campaign actually took really short time. I want to make this even shorter, but then basically what you can see is only take you like around 2 weeks to 3 weeks something, because you also need time to do the internship, the attraction campaign. So how you can doing this is you, for the product team, you need to calculate the timeline of sign up approval, when you need the sign up, when you need the approval, basically. And when you have this goal, so for example, you need to say that in the second month, at the end of second month, I need to have the applicant for the opportunity marketing in some country, for example. Then you, from this timeline, you do the backward planning, and then you let the marketing know that how much time they have to do the campaign. So based on the time we have, we can decide to do a big one or we can do a small one, but then effective. And then how much time for the timeline is good enough. And because usually, I don't know if you have this thinking or not, but then when I was in my term, right, I actually don't think about do attraction and then get the result right now. I usually planning for doing attraction for the next 6 months. Because to be honest, basically right now we need to build a pool of customer and we need to have it, we need to nurture them. So we cannot like boosting them for set up right away. But then this is just the opinion that I have. But then for you in this case, what I'm trying to say is you also need to aware that after you launching, it doesn't mean that you're gonna have set up right away. But then that's why you need to make it more effective, make it do the lead nurturing fast, stronger, and then have a very clear expectation. So that you don't lag with any kind of timeline. Also, I think that for the launching, right? The launching is the first step of building a very strong marketing and sales funnel for the whole entity. And if you want to grow this marketing and sales funnel, you need to plan the sheet so that you need to build a big pool of customer for the future. And then you need to do watering nutrition. And after you do watering nutrition, then you harvest. So it's exactly the same with how the launching and then the startup gonna bring to you. The launching is the planning the seed so that you can build a big pool of customer first, and then based on lead nurturing between you and also marketing, then you're gonna consider nurture them. And when in the time of harvesting, you're gonna harvest all of the startup applicant and approve. Basically like that. Okay, so I intend to tell a bit more about rent advocacy campaign, but then I think it's not, I don't have a lot of time. It's just basically for rent advocacy campaign. If you have any concern, I already put the FAQ here. Basically, I would recommend you to do it before you launch the campaign. And don't mention anything, before you launch the new product. Don't mention anything about the new logo or something before you officially launch it. Just say develop leadership with Isaac. And then the BA campaign is an optional for you. You can do it, but also don't need to do it if you don't have much time. But just remember that this brand advocacy campaign, the objective is building a brand loyalty and also building the loyalty of the customer with you. So, you can do it now or you can do it later when you already have the first experience of, first real life, for example. But then if you want to do it very quick, like maximum is 1 month maximum, but then usually it's only 2 to 3 weeks is good enough. Phyllis, I will leave you like 5 minutes only so you can say about
my screen.
Do you want me to show the picture?
It's fine, I can share screen. Marketing, right? For
the strategy one.
Okay, cool. So for OGT, you maybe hear about it before already, but then just to recap, like on what are the things that we're going to have synergy with marketing together. Then I will quickly go for it. So in here, right? So for this year, what we ideally want to do is we want to have a customer-centric process in terms of marketing and sales process as well as S&D alignment. So at the end of the day, our outcome is we want to have a team, a professional consultant team in OGT that able to recommend the right opportunity to EPs based on their the applicants based on their profile. And also at the same time, we want to providing the personalized information to the EP during our lead nurturing process. So this is the things that we're currently working on. So the only word that I want you to remember is persona. So in the coming time, when we feedbacking of the campaign and operation, we will be based on the persona that we are finalizing right now between OGT and marketing. So we have a hub on it. So the information has been aligned between IGT, OGT, and marketing already. So that persona should be good enough. So the end outcome by 2020 that we want to have is we want to have a our current state is most of the entity when we trying to manage our lead, we don't have any personalization in the process. But then by the end of 2020, our ideal state is at least we will have personalization, at least single channel. For example, email nurturing is your like lead nurturing process, then maybe at least email we will be personalized. But ideal state would be how we can have multiple channels that are able to personalize. And this part, mostly you will work with me in terms of the digital marketing ecosystem on how to build a system to support the lead together. Yeah. So this is so far on it. And the mostly synergy that we're going to have is on this strategy. It would be about customer journey. These are the deliverables. Customer journey creation, global campaign customization and feedback, and also some NEC evaluation as well. So to let you have an overview on what are things we're going to synergize with you guys is we have persona, and then we create the product packaging already. So based on these two things, with synergy with marketing will be based on these two, have global campaign customization and feedback based on persona. So this will be the first one. And secondly, we have been developing the marketing sales funnel between OGT and marketing in Monday co-working space, and also the package campaign alignment in terms of timeline management as well. We have also do it on Monday as well. So this will be mostly the part with synergy marketing. And for the remaining part of the customer journey, we have been working with RGT already for the synergy. So the upcoming things that going to be responsible for marketing, or if you're OGT that you're going to be responsible for marketing, then you will work with me for the one that about product launching. So she just explained just now. So make sure you'll be aware on it if you are OGT who taking marketing. And for marketing, thank you so much. I totally rely on you, and I have some trust for you guys and also me as well. So the second one will be about digital marketing ecosystem. I think this is the best project that I've ever seen in regional office. So I personally like it a lot, and it really like fit with the direction that when Generation Z people want to have more personalization in terms of their customer experience. So these three things will be mostly the things that we're going to synergize between marketing and OGT in the coming like time for the upcoming strategy. For persona, we have done already. So everything you see on the with picture, right, is something that we've done already. Okay. We just mostly on finalization and tracking process only. So So if you want to know what are the OGT resources that we have been using before, so these are all, you can go to the master sheet. So you can find a tab called co-working space. So you can find all of the things that OGT has been working in the co-working space, and you can find all of the resources that we have. Yeah. So thank you so much, and thank you, marketing. I love you guys a lot.